Hello, this is Jose Luis here at Parametric Camp, and welcome to another video in our playlist, Having Some Fun with AI. In this video, I would like to teach you how to add credits to your developer account in OpenAI. So this is a March 2024 update, because before March, in February and in January and etc., the way OpenAI used to work is that you would just add your credit card, and then however much API you would use, then they will bill you at the end of the month. But starting in March, they have changed the system, and which is how I, for example, used to work, remember? Now, the problem is that starting in March, they have switched to a new model that is called prepaid billing. What that means is that basically, you cannot just be charged by how much API you use by the end of the month. What you have to do now is basically top up your account. You have to basically send some money beforehand, and then any API calls that you make to OpenAI services will be discounted from this money that you added, prepaying for it. I also want to make sure that you understand that this system, the system for adding credits to your developer account, the API usage inside of OpenAI, is different from, for example, the old method that we used to have for example, DALL-E. DALL-E used to have its own app. You could just come here, you could just buy some credits for DALL-E, and then you could just generate synthetic images. This, for example, with DALL-E 2 is obsolete, and as you can see here, they're going to discontinue this program in April. So probably in the future, if you watch this video, you will not have the DALL-E dedicated API, sorry, the DALL-E dedicated app anymore. And if you want to generate synthetic images with DALL-E 3, you just use it through ChatGPT automatically. I also want to make sure that you understand that this is also different from the ChatGPT premium account. So OpenAI offers, as of March 2024, this ChatGPT app where you can pay a monthly fee and then you can just like generate things with ChatGPT. And if you had the premium account, which I don't have, you could also access DALL-E 3 image generations, etc., etc. This video is specific for developers, specific if you want to use the API in OpenAI. So what does that look like? If you have an account, and you can watch my previous video in this series on how to get your OpenAI API key, a card to that video will be showing up in the corner. If you already have created an account, a developer account on OpenAI, then you will have access to your settings here. This is where you will create your OpenAI keys, right? I showed this in my previous video. And then in usage, you will have, if you have already used your OpenAI account using API calls, then you will have some metrics of usage. But if you're starting from scratch, then very likely what you will have to do is a couple of things. You will have to go to the billing section inside of settings. This number will be zero, probably on your end. And then the next thing that you need to do is first, you need to add a payment method. So here you go and you basically enter your credit card details so that you can add your credit card account to OpenAI. And then the next thing that you need to do is go back to overview. This will be zero. And then what you can do is you can add credit balance to your account. So for example, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to top up my account with $5 additional, right? And then I'm going to continue. I'm going to add this, blah, blah, blah. I'm going to confirm the payment. And then the moment I do this, you will see that, let's give it a second, that my credit balance is now $9, right? What this means is that now I can start using the API services. So DALL-E through the API, ChatGPT through the API, and the money that those calls cost will be discounted, will be billed to my credit. And the moment that credit becomes zero, then you will not be able to use the service anymore. You can enable auto recharge. You can enable OpenAI adding more credits automatically to your system if you so wish. I kind of like to keep it under control. I don't mind if I get an error that I can't use the system anymore and then be manually, just to keep things under control, you know? I have also found that if you had old API keys that were using the old system, I have found that my keys did not work with the new system, the prepaid billing. So I actually had to create a new secret key and replace it in all my apps for the new billing system to work. So this might be the case for you as well. And if you are new to this playlist and to OpenAI, and you may want to know why would you want to use the API service as opposed to just the DALL-E app or the ChatGPT app, then I have good news for you. I have a full playlist where I'm going to teach you how to create your own apps that use the OpenAI services for image generation and text completion on the background, and then how you can become and be playful and connect these services to Grasshopper, Python, and Node.js, create your own web app, etc., etc. So if you're interested in that, make sure you check the playlist that is in the description of this video. All right, so let me actually go ahead and teach you how to do that in the next videos. Thanks a lot, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.